Hey guys, it's your boy Corpairs, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Final Art Career mode, where last time I left off. He sealed the winning of the league with this win over Willem 2-3, and sealed the league title. And I also progressed to the final of the Dutch Cup with a 1-0 win over FC 20. You will see the final and the last league game in this episode. So yeah, this is gonna be the last of the Final Art Career Mode videos. I could have done a video was showing these matches, but considering I am in the final and I'll be simming this game against but you'll see the game against Gorgon, after which I will lift the Eredivisie. But before I get into the matches, I want to show you the results of the games I simmed. So, we start off with a disappointing 0-0 against AZ. Of course, the results didn't matter at this point. Nice 4-0 win over Ado Den Haag. Mark Zanetta banging a few goals. Of the games that I simmed, Zanetta scored a lot of goals and Kramer didn't score one. He might have gotten assists, but I didn't look at assists before or after. Well, that's a interesting way to get into April, which started with another draw. This time 1-1 against the Graf, the DG. Disappointing. Another game against Ajax came up. I picked up a 2-0 win, with Stendetta scoring again. In fact, I think he might have scored both goals, actually, in that match. And then again, against my cup final opponents, Rudad JC, where I beat him 1-0. Elias scored the only goal in that match. Be interesting to see if something similar happens in the final. Be very weird if it ended 1-0 and Elia scored the winning goal again. Not impossible. The first team is ready to go. So, let's go. Following the Amsterdam Arena, huh?
What we know today, Alan Smith alongside me here on this great day for this.
All right, let's do this.
Got the Dutch Cup final here. Be bags of technique and good play involved.
When I started this career, my minimal goal was to at least make sure that I did exactly as Feyenoord did in real life. They won the Dutch Cup in real life as well. I don't know who they played because I don't really follow the Dutch league too closely. I only vaguely look at the league table every now and again.
And for Feyenoord, this is how they're going to line up. Well, we've gone with a 4-3-3 formation here.
When I went to look up
the way you see it, Alan,
the
it can be adjusted. It could almost
stats
be a 5-1 if they
decide to come over all defensive.
When Feyenoord actually last won the Eredivisie, so I could have my facts straight. Hit that. It was 1998-99 season. I saw that they won the Dutch Cup in the season that just passed. So I was like, oh, they won the cup. I'll have to make sure that I at least do that. And that is exactly what the goal is. It has been since the start of the career mode. So, I'm only one win away from doing that. And I'm completing the double. Well, while I haven't gotten the Eredivisie title yet, I have won it, so.
Distance, but the keeper still had a lot to do, and he did it really well. Can't keep the ball at the moment.
This will mark the career mode as 100% successful.
The opponent off his stride. Nice move to get away from the defender.
If I were to somehow lose it, would only be like 50% successful, and I would have. I don't know. Would it be better to only win the league and instead of only winning the cup? Because before this past season, and I think it was 07-08 that Feyenoord last won the Dutch Cup before that. So, not as long a wait.
It's a goal!
But luckily, I won't have to choose one or the other, because I'm getting both. Because this keeper is stupid enough, he passes it straight out to Kramer, who bangs it, makes it 2-0. Well, instantly, yeah, I'm doing better in a game I'm playing instead of one I simmed. And Kramer, after a few games with no goal, well, suddenly bangs into out of nowhere.
Player's done well here until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right idea, but couldn't find his man. It's out over the touchline. Supporting player alongside. Chance for the cross. There's the ball in. Chooses to punch it.
Yeah, right. Mel is actually the only player in this starting lineup who's played. He has played in every single cup game, because of course he was on the second team until Kongolo got injured.
That's really the way to get the ball out of the danger zone. Played down the wing, keeping the wide attack going.
So,
first touch was poor.
Well, can take some kind of joy from that particular stat.
And here's the shot. Could get his cross in now.
Count. Kramer doesn't mean it. Come to Valhalla.
It's a useful ball in.
Couch. Oh. It's his last ever cup game. Be great if he can go out with a goal. Well, I'm not going to go out of my way to get him one.
Lost his marker cleverly.
The opportunity should arise. I will give. I will try and take it.
Well, there he was. For the hat trick.
Oh, that was a terrible cross. Oh,
you'd put your house on that, wouldn't you? And the verdict on added time is 2 minutes. El Hero Elia. He might be through.
Elia.
Elia! It's another very good save.
Ah, way too easy. I power puffed it.
We weren't sure when we came here for the Dutch Cup final which of these two sides would actually.
That was a terrible shot.
We are now ready for the start of the second half of this splendid game.
Both sets of players really have been pumped
still
up.
Still 2-0.
Produced some cracking football before the break.
Thank goodness, missing chances doesn't take away any goals. Couch! Oh, he almost got it. Maybe from the corner.
And the ball knocked away.
Maybe from the follow-up corner.
The ball.
Jamel! Oh, off the post! That would have been a perfect way to complete the cup journey, Heifert or Jamel.
Not often, Alan, do you see one man have one half like he's had.
On top of his game out there, and I'm sure.
Come on, Clerk.
Thinking about grabbing his hat trick in the second half.
Elia.
Oh, yeah. Someone make a run. Ohana. Fouled.
Could be a booking here.
I'll take it. It slows down the play. He get a yellow card. It was nice to with your jersey. Hey there, friend.
Saw it all the way, the goalkeeper. And it's comfortable in the end.
That was, not exactly what I was hoping would happen. Wait! Oh, yeah! The flag stayed down and Stendetta's header is terrible!
Alan Smith on the replay here. He's got that through clever reading of the game. Intercepting and getting possession back for his team.
Kaut.
Elia!
Elia! Ooh! Almost gives Kaut an assist.
Corner given.
And there's the goal!
Oh, but Elia scores this time. Bangs it in. 3-0.
And what a good header.
That is the cup. Well and truly won.
Another angle on that goal.
He actually header. I think Kaut's header would have gone wide if he had connected with it. So maybe it was good that Elia kind of stole it from him.
He's beaten his man. Out wide, they were in a good position until that defender acted very promptly and decisively.
Out for a throw. Jamel.
One back very
quick. Ohana. Elia.
Trust it well. And he claims the cross. Stop the game for the free kick.
It's going to be a card for Kramer.
Well, the ref's given a foul here, and it's a bad one. Yellow.
Yeah, no surprise there.
One yellow card each.
It's always tough for players when they are substituted. It's more, of course, a regular occurrence these
Although
days.
Kramer didn't do anything wrong. He was just...
The crowd aren't helping,
it was the keeper's fault. No, they fell over Kramer.
You don't want to be taken off in this sort of an atmosphere.
You don't, but it comes with the territory. And the manager, I think, just feeling it's that time in the match where he needs a little bit more
went
energy.
Straight into the opposition player. So, yeah. Alamedi! Good save.
Done well to stop that one.
Granted, I didn't exactly... put in the best shot, but still. Oh. Save deserves some spotlight.
Here comes
Ohana. Stender can't connect with the header again. Kaut loses out the ball. Oh.
Juric.
Oh, yeah.
And
that didn't go out? Wow. Must have been like right on the line, because it looked like it went out to me. And again, it's on the far side of the pitch, so even in the game, it's pretty hard to tell.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the opposition manager.
But what's not hard to tell is there's the full-time whistle. The cup is won. It's a 100% successful season. And Dirk Kuyt's last season as a professional footballer is ending.
Just when it mattered.
Glory and more glory.
Have been a terrific team. It's all fitted in perfectly for these boys.
So what's hilarious is their rivals with Ajax and their celebrating winning a trophy in their stadium. Way!
Well, there's only so many trophies on offer during the course of the season.
That is extremely hysterical.
Footballer to be in this position, to be on that podium, wonderful stuff.
And of course, he was already captain when I came here, but since it's his last season, I was never gonna not let him have his moment.
Description.
Not just for the cup. In about 15 minutes, he'll have it in the league as well. That's a bit of a foreshadowing. I mean, no way, they can't stop me from winning the league. PSV definitely cannot catch me. It's only two games left. And there's the, this of the goals, top goal scorers. As you can see, Stenda is only two behind Kramer with two games remaining. Oh, it's all very exciting in going into the last two games. Only 1 million. Oh yeah, Traore wanted to start. Whoops. Maybe I should have brought him on. My bad. Offer rescinded. Look at all those offers rescinded. And I don't care about any of them. The last home game of the season. To make it up to Traore, I'm going to throw him in. With all the second team, a 1-1 draw. Dirk Kuyt scores in his last home game he came on. In fact, he instantly scored in the very next minute. And they equalized 11 minutes later from the penalty spot. Traore picked up an injury, but it didn't bring him off, so I'm going to assume he's okay. No, he's out for 2 weeks. That's a good thing. There's only one game left, and it's not going to matter because he wasn't going to play in it anyway. Doesn't matter who I put on the bench. They won't be coming on. Unless there's an injury. And even then, Ruben will probably be my first choice as a substitution if something happens to Kramer. So, the last game of the career mode. The last game of a legendary career, or no matter what anyone says. And he may not get the recognition he deserves, but damn it, he's a fantastic player, and I for one consider him a legend. And there is the confirmation. He will be This will be his last professional game. And what a way to end the season, as it will be first versus second. I don't think they're going to finish second, though, because if I beat them, PSV will go above them. But technically, it's first versus second. It's the champions versus technically the runners-up, or at least the third-place team. I don't want any other matches interfering with the match. Let's get into the final game of the Feyenoord career mode. And let's win the trophy. Hey, well, I've already won the trophy. Let's lift the trophy. Yeah, and sorry for hitting the mic again. And gotta work on that.
Hello everybody, Martin Tyler.
There's also an internal battle for top goal scorer.
And we're hoping to bring you some fine action.
Although Max and will need a hat trick to get it. And he'll have to hope that Kramer doesn't score at all in this match. Oh, Kramer's gonna score for 3 minutes into it. It was pretty much set up by Sten Dez's shot being saved. 3 minutes into the
classy goal, Alan.
The final game of the season. Kramer headers it to Stendez's shot is safe. Kramer puts it in. Meaning even if Stendez scores a hat-trick now, that will mean they tie. But Stendez wants top goal scorer. He'll need to score 4 goals. It's not impossible.
Here's the chance to get in the cross.
And trying to avoid losing the ball. Oh, he puts it over the bar after all of that. I went for the finesse and he puts it over the bar.
Just a quick word on this super scoring season for the visiting team today.
Well, they play such an open, expansive game. It does leave them vulnerable at times, but they've just been outscoring the opposition.
Now they've got a chance.
I don't think I'll be scoring 100 goals. I'd need 6 more.
Poor touch and the possession's gone away.
And even if it is for a celebration, I don't really feel like humiliating Gorgon.
Gone out over the touchline, that'll be a throw to the opposition. El Hero Elia.
Elia. Wins the ball back and Valhanna straight at the keeper. Really? Of all the places you could hit your shot, you hit it straight at the keeper.
I've got the ball in the middle of the pitch here.
That was quite idiotic, actually.
The goalkeeper can just come out and pick that up. And that's a throw. Good skill, just to lift the ball there at the right moment. Successful tackle. Rasmus Lindgren. Got away from him.
Calamity. Valhalla.
A
wins their corner.
Well, that's another. There's another angle coming up here, Alan. We've got the last touch, the defender, so that will be a corner. Well, we've got a battle within the war today, haven't we, with the player getting his track at his old teammates.
Yeah, and I think it's always an emotional time when you face your former club, so you just want to concentrate on doing
even
yourself
his
justice.
Late season form, Kramer's still probably going to get the like lowest toll of any of my
the pass
top
really
scorers
in
FIFA.
One.
I think like the previous low was 30, and he's on 26. So the fact that he's 4 behind the previous low means he's going to set a new record. I don't know if 26 goals is a record for the Eredivisie. It might not. I don't think it will be. Like I said, I'm not a huge follower of the Eredivisie. But I can it's not. I'm
going to
go with it's not until... Unless one of you can tell me in the comments below if I'm wrong. And if it is some kind of record. But it will definitely be a record for me, but it's not one Kramer will want himself to be associated with.
Referee blows.
That is the lowest any of my top scorers in any career mode I've ever scored.
It's a quick break.
You could put it down to the fact that the Eredivisie is shorter than some of the other.
Well, they've extended their lead in this game, and the gap between these two sides is reflected now on the scoreline.
Than some of the other her leagues, but that's not really an excuse. It has 18 teams, the same as the Bundesliga.
Restarting at 2-0.
And in my Bundesliga career mode, I got, I think it was 35 pass. Goals.
He's giving it straight to the opposition.
Is at least with.
And the ball's got away from it.
Dritch. I'll have to look back to make sure, but I know for a fact that he got over 30. So,
possession given away once.
Really, it was his own lack of form for most of the season.
Goal with a header. Super stop by the goalkeeper. He's hung on to the ball as well. He's caught offside. You see what he's trying to do. It's all about the timing of the run.
Counts offside. I'm sure he'll really miss those kind of calls.
He'll feel good about that. A really strong and clean tackle.
With all the sarcasm in the world.
That is a free kick.
Really? That's a foul.
Can be a match winner, this lad, but today, no. And it was one of his lesser performances. I think it's a bit hard on him that the supporters seem to be happy to see him coming off.
Yeah, that's the life of a winger sometimes. You are dependent on your service and obviously dependent on what you do with it.
And here comes the counter-attack.
I was hoping he would pass it over, but he passed it backwards for some reason.
These two have got a great understanding with their passing.
Dickhead.
El Ahmadi.
There's Kout.
Kout!
And there we go. Kout scores in his fine. Well, professional game.
Lose your class. You might lose your legs a touch, as this lad has, but
what might be his last professional goal?
To
he's got 18 this season, which isn't Not bad, no.
That's given them a comfortable situation.
Of course, it's not
3-0 as the game gets underway.
Best hole in his career, but you know, it's still respectful. Oh, for a winger.
He's moved in, trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
Normally, wingers are more get more assists.
To head the ball, quite a lot, I think. Plenty of aerial balls are going to be coming their way in the next few moments.
This FIFA, I've noticed that my midfielders have bagged me a lot more goals than they have in previous FIFAs. Which is increased even more so by that goal from Valhanna, which I think is only like his... Yeah, I was going to say his third or fourth in the whole season.
Two teams, much the better side.
You know, he hadn't scored in pretty much ages.
4-0. Kramer. Well, that'll be a throw. Dirk out.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well, it was woeful.
Kout fights off the challenge. Ah, oh, the defender provided it enough. I guess you could say distraction to prevent Kout getting in his shot properly and perhaps making it 5-0.
Able to make a good interception. Dirk out.
Stender. The defense clears it, and there's the full-time whistle.
They have won the league title. Fantastic.
Well, you've got to look at them over the course of the season, Martin.
Well, a 4-0 win to wrap up the season and the career mode. Ooh. Fantastic big effort throughout the whole season from all the players involved. And it's a great send-off for our Dirk Kuyt, who can now retire and be with his family or whatever he plans to do. And there they go to get one of the worst trophies in the game. Game purely because of what it looks like.
Milk the moment.
I mean, it doesn't look like it should be given to a league winner.
That's not always the case.
I mean, pretty much it's a plate. It's pretty much a goddamn plate. While it's a big plate, it still looks like a goddamn plate.
Credit to the organizers for the way it's staged. It sets it up.
I will let the players enjoy their moment. Thanks for watching the whole Feyenoord career mode. Make sure and check in tomorrow to see the start of a new career mode when I go to France with Marseille. And until then, enjoy the celebrations, and I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
With the way this manager likes to play.
At full extension, the goalkeeper makes the save.